What is going on, everybody? It's Alex back with another video, and today I have some pretty sad news because it is official. It's been rumored for a while, but unfortunately today we got the confirmation that E3 2020 has in fact been canceled. Now, some of you may be wondering why this is relating at all to Saints Row 5, why this is such a big deal, and why me, and I'm assuming some other people will follow suit and make videos regarding this, is because it seemed almost guaranteed that we would be hearing about Saints Row 5 at E3 this year. Late last year, we got confirmation that the game was deep in development, we knew that it was in the works, and that we would hear about it at some point this year. And then if you guys watched my last video, you know, we kind of discussed this and looked at the development and things that would be happening throughout the year and when they would actually talk about the game. And as I mentioned, it was basically guaranteed that we would be getting the announcement, the reveal, and hopefully gameplay and everything like that around, you know, the time of E3, which was supposed to happen June 9th through June 11th. So that was the event, that was the time frame that we were looking at actually preparing and getting to see the game for the very first time. The full announcement, the full reveal. But unfortunately, as I said before, E3 has been canceled, meaning that is no longer guaranteed, at least, to be the time that we get to see the game for the first time. So now it kind of opens up the question once again of when we are actually going to get the full reveal for the new Saints Row game. Now, although that obviously was all speculation and it wasn't confirmed to be unveiled at E3 2020, there was no other, you know, reasonable time for them to do it. There was no other event that made a whole lot of sense for them to do the reveal. So it kind of, there was that little bit of comfort because we could rest easy and know that 99% it will happen there. But since it has been canceled, we have absolutely no idea when we're going to get it. And it could really happen at any time because there's no major event at this point that would give them a reasonable time frame to actually do their reveal, which means almost exclusively, they're going to have to do it on their own. They're not going to piggyback off of some kind of event or something like that. They would have to, you know, release a trailer on their YouTube channel or something and promote it a different way. But what this means is having the comfort of knowing exactly when we're going to get to see the game is no longer. But what's a little bit frustrating about it is it's not like E3 was the most likely event and then there was a second best option. No, I mean, there really was no second best option. It was either they did it at E3 or they do it themselves, you know, through the YouTube channel or something like that. And now it looks like that is exactly what's going to happen, which means it could happen at any time. They could literally drop a trailer on their YouTube channel, on their Twitter, at any point, and we really don't have any indication of when that's actually going to happen. Now, although this takes away any indication of when we think we're going to get the trailer or the reveal or something like that, whatever they were planning, they were kind of time constrained. You know, they had a certain date. I'm sure they already knew exactly what day, what time during the event that they were going to actually be doing this, and they would probably have everything done far before then, and then just kind of hold on to it and wait before they can actually reveal it. Now, they don't have that time constraint, meaning that it doesn't matter when they reveal it, they can do it on their own terms, and they can make it happen without having to wait on this event, meaning most likely we are actually going to now be getting the full reveal before we would if we had to wait until E3. So assuming E3 was still going on and they were going to do the reveal there, we would have to wait about 3 months to see the full reveal. Now, it's at least not guaranteed that we would have to wait 3 months. Maybe they're still going to wait for that exact time and, you know, release it on June 9th, June 10th, whatever, whenever they were supposed to do it. Maybe they'll just, you know, continue as planned and reveal it there. But maybe now that they don't have that time constraint, maybe when everything's done and everything's planned and ready to go, they're gonna kind of drip feed through their Twitter or YouTube or something like that, build up the hype, and then release it on their own terms, maybe as soon as next month. Now, I don't necessarily think that it's gonna happen next month, but I still find it very hard to believe that we would get the trailer any later than when E3 was scheduled. Now, once again, this is kind of frustrating because we kind of knew when to expect the reveal, and now it's really completely up in the air again. We have absolutely no idea. but it is nice to know that it's at least possible that we could be getting the reveal a little earlier than expected. But make sure to let me know your thoughts on this down in the comments. Do you think this is a good thing for Saints Row 5, or do you think it's bad? Either way, thank you guys for checking out the video. If you guys enjoyed it, make sure to drop a like, make sure to subscribe if you haven't already. Thank you guys for the support. Peace out. Didn't come to my birthday party, rude, but they all found time to go fight the warrior. Play this and be like some...